Welcome to Can You Beat Sekiro Without Attacking? The Ultimate Gundy Run, Part 2, let's go! I told you in the last part that this challenge turned out to be very time consuming, and I really didn't know how much of an underestimation this was. I had to put several hours into single boss fights this time. There are no speedrun skips in this part. I killed the one-armed bandit, Orochimaru's wives, the protagonist of Elden Ring, the human centipede fanboys, Sister Lily, and most importantly, Genichiro Mother Complex. And again, I decided to not show every fight from start to finish. Instead, I will upload the important ones separately because otherwise this video would be too long. Let's jump straight into the details. I started with the Lone Shadow Longswordman. This guy was by far the most challenging of all bosses so far. The only good thing about this fight is that he constantly attacks you, which helps you to fill his posture bar. There are three other points I'm going to mention. First, I didn't know he had a posture buffing move, very similar to the generals in this game. In my former playthroughs, I spammed him with my attacks and he never showed this buff. It was kinda interesting. Second point, the boss arena. The camera killed me an unbelievable amount of times. It's so frustrating when Sekiro blocks off your vision and the Lone Shadow kicks your balls. Third point, the jump kick counters. Because of the small room, your jump kicks would fail because Sekiro would do a wall jump instead of Goomba jumping the enemy. And I really have a feeling that something is not right with the Lone Shadow's hitbox if you tried to jump kick him. It just wouldn't work so many times. I don't know, maybe I'm just bad. But you can watch this fight in a separate video I uploaded a week ago. Next one on the list was Snake Eyes Shirahagi the lady at the poison pool. I decided to visit her sister first, even if she is an optional boss, because there were no mobs around her, it was very easy to practice with her. This fight was very intense. At best, this fight takes 10 whole minutes. And if you get grabbed, you lose your entire progress. I'm only 90% joking when I say this fight made me suicidal, but other than the time aspect, this fight wasn't much of a challenge, because her attack pool is very limited. I was kind of surprised when I found out you can't deflect your grab attack, but maybe this fight would have been impossible without this feature. You can watch the entire fight in a separate video in my boss fight playlist. I decided to visit Mount Kongo to farm some prayer beads and the attack power from the monkeys. I totally forgot that you can't fight the monkeys unless you bully Genichiro first. Believe it or not, I took this exact path in my first playthrough because I couldn't find the secret window of the Ashina Castle. I was such a casual. I'm not wasting much time on the mini-bosses. The Armored Warrior has zero posture recovery, which makes this fight a cakewalk. And the centipedes are meant to be fought by deflecting, so 3 easy earned prayer beads. I skipped Orin because every time I get to meet her, my soul hurts and I want to put a basket on top of my head. I decided to face the corrupted monk like a real man. Hand-to-hand combat. I approached him with heavy steps and started the battle with a war cry. I told her, "Finally, a worthy opponent. Our battle will be legendary." The battle lasted 3 days. Neither of us rested. We had sworn the battle would be over with only one of us leaving the battlefields. And I was the destined one. The chosen warrior of Wall Jump Death Blows. And the last boss of this video, the alpha of the beta males, Genichiro Ashina. It is impossible to kill this guy without dealing damage beforehand. He's a calm fighter. He's not attacking constantly like the Lone Shadow. After a few swings, he will wait patiently for your attacks. And I would have told him about the challenge, but Sekiro doesn't know the talk no jutsu. Okay, here's a little quiz for you. What do you do if you have to damage your opponent, but you decided to not attack him? A. You give up. B. You rethink your life choices. C. You let your depression take the wheel. Or D. You take a crash course in Taekwondo. The answer is always D. You need exactly 90 successful jump kicks per health bar.
Yes, I counted them.
To get his health low enough that this fight is doable with deflects and counters only. And I did it. I deserve a freaking medal for this one. In his last phase, he is much more aggressive. Maybe it's possible to beat him without the jump kicks there, but I didn't even bother. My rules didn't mention lightning reversals at all. There are no regular run attacks, nor are they combat arts or prosthetic tools. I would consider them a counterattack just like the Mikiri counter and the jump kicks. So I reversed like 5 lightnings and finished him off. and you can see the entire fight uploaded separately. And he was the last boss for this video. I will deal with the guardian ape Emma and Ishin in the next part, because this will give us the shortest ending, and you know this challenge is about beating the game at any means. So, can you beat Sekiro without attacking and without prosthetic tools? We will find out together. If you have other challenge ideas in mind, feel free to tell me in the comments, but for now, I will continue this one. If you don't want to miss out the next part, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to check out my other challenge video, Can You Beat Sekiro Without Running? That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like. If you think you wasted your time, feel free to dislike. See ya next time.